Hi guys, good day, it's me, Teacher MJ. Our topic for today class, it's all about solving quadratic inequalities. So without further ado, let's do this topic. Now, I will give you three examples class for you to really understand this one. So this will be our example number one, x squared minus 2x minus 15 is greater than or equal to 0. Now for number two and number three class, I will just make another video for this one because we need to explain class number one step by step. Alright, so feel free to see the video class with regards to number 2 and number 3. Now, once again class, before solving quadratic inequalities, you need to master class on how to make solution sets. So if you want to learn more on how to make solution sets, I will just put the link on the description down below. Alright, so this will be the quadratic inequality symbols. We have the greater than, we have the less than, we have greater than or equal, we have less than or equal. For the included, we have greater than or equal, less than or equal, we use closed circle, and then brackets. Now, we will explain that later on, class. Why do we use a closed circle? So, for not included, we have greater than, we have less than, open circle. Now, once again, we will explain that later on. Why do we use an open circle? And then parentheses. For infinity, it's always parentheses. Alright, so let's start answering this one. Now, first step, class, is you need to factor this quadratic inequality. So once again class, I know that you have your factoring before solving quadratic inequalities. So to factor this out, you find two numbers that when you multiply the two numbers, you will get negative 15. When you combine, you will get negative 2. So for negative 15, of course, there would be negative 5 and then positive 3, right? Because if you multiply negative 5 multiplied by positive 3, you will get negative 15. If you combine negative 5 combined with positive 3, you will get negative 2. So therefore, the factors, there would be x minus 5, and the other one, there would be x plus 3, and then simply copy greater than or equal to 0. Once again, class, first step, you factor the quadratic inequality. Now, second step, class, you equate this one into 0 for us to get the critical points. Once again, class, second step, equate this one into 0. So this will be x minus 5, and then x plus 3, once again, quantity x minus 5, quantity x plus 3 equals 0. Question, sir, why do we need to equate this one into 0? Because we need to get the critical points, we need to get the x value for us to locate this one on the number line. Once again, class, we need to get the x values for us to locate this one on the number line. We call that one class critical points. Alright, so equate this one into 0. So this will be x minus 5 equals 0. The other one, x plus 3 equals 0. So to get the value of x, simply transpose negative 5 from left to right. So this is negative, it will be positive 5. So do not forget, class, once you transfer from this equal sign, you change the sign. This is negative, it becomes positive 5. And for 3, this is positive, it will be negative 3. And this is what we call plus our critical points. Now, once you get your critical points, class, you locate this one on the number line. So, you draw a number line. Of course, class, we know that for positive 5, it will be on the right. And then negative 3, it will be on the left, right? Because if this is 0, on the center part, this is 0. After 0, those are positive numbers. So, there will be positive 1, positive 2, positive 3, and so on. So, positive 5 will be here. And then negative 3 will be on the left side. So this is negative 3. Alright, so once again, this is negative 3 will be on the left side, and then positive 5 will be on the right side. Now, since you have greater than or equal, we will be using a closed circle. So once again, class, if you have greater than or equal, you will be using a closed circle. So we will use a closed circle on the top of negative 3, and then another closed circle on the top of positive 5. And then we'll be checking this region class, this one right here, and this one right here. Now, after you check the region class, just make the solution sets and then you're all set. Now, the question there class is, why do we use a closed circle instead of open circle? Now, you will be using a closed circle class if it's greater than or equal. Question, why is that, sir? Because if you substitute this value class for x, which is negative 3, from this given quadratic inequality, the statement class will be true. If it's true, you will be using a closed circle. Once again, class, If you substitute this value negative 3 and then positive 5 from this quadratic inequality, the statement plus will be true. You will satisfy the equation. So let's check that one class. Because there are some teachers class, they will be asking you a question. Why do we use a closed circle instead of open circle? And your answer for that one class, if you substitute this x value from this equation, the statement is true. That's why you use a closed circle. So let's check that one class using this factor. X minus 5, the other one is x plus 3, is greater than or equal to 0. Once again class, no need to check class with regards to negative 3 and positive 5. Just in case the teacher will ask you, why do we use a closed circle? Because it's automatic class, if you have greater than or equal, less than or equal, always use a closed circle. If you have only greater than or less than, use the open circle. Now, since we have greater than or equal, that's why we use a closed circle. Just in case, if the teacher will ask you, why do we use a closed circle other than greater than or equal? Your answer, class, because if you substitute this x value, you will satisfy the equation that the statement is true. So let's check that one. Once again, this will be the quadratic inequality. So our x is negative 3, so negative 3 minus 5. And then x is negative 3. Once again, substitute x, which is negative 3. So negative 3 minus 5. And then x is negative 3 plus 3 is greater than or equal to 0. So negative 3 combined with negative 5, both negative. Simply copy negative sign and then add the numbers. 3 plus 5, that's 8. Once again, because if you're combining both negative, simply copy negative sign, then you add the numbers. That would be negative 8. And then negative 3 plus 3, of course, this will be 0. So cancel this out and this will be 0. And then simply copy greater than or equal to 0. Alright, so negative 8 times 0, that is 0, greater than or equal to 0. Now, is 0 greater than 0? Of course not. 0 is not greater than 0. Now, next question, is 0 equal to 0? Because we have or. Now, is 0 equal to 0? Yep, 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, class, the statement is true. That 0 is equal to 0 because we have greater than or equal to 0. So this is true. So that's why, class, you have a closed circle. Once again, class, that's why you have a closed circle. But no need to check, class, why do we use a closed circle or open circle? So just in case, class, the teacher will ask you, why do we use a closed circle? So that's the thing that you will do, class. Simply substitute this x value and then you will satisfy the equation. All right, even if you use positive 5, class, the statement will be also true. So let's try, class, positive 5. Let's check. So x is positive 5. So 5 minus 5. X is positive 5. 5 plus 3 is greater than or equal to 0. 5 minus 5, that is 0. Once again, class, I just simply substitute the value of x, which is positive 5. So let's check if it's true. If it's true, we use a closed circle. So 5 minus 5, that's 0. That is 0. And then 5 plus 3, that is 8. Is greater than or equal to 0. 0 times 8, that is 0, greater than or equal to 0. Is 0 greater than 0? Nope, it's not. Is 0 equal to 0? Yep, 0 is equal to 0. We have greater than or equal. So therefore, the statement is true because we have or equal. So therefore, the statement is true. So that's why, class, you have a closed circle. But once again, class, in solving quadratic inequalities, no need to check, class, with regards to these critical points. So we will be checking, class, this region, okay, this region right here. So we will be checking this region, this middle part, and then this region. So you will use any number, class, after negative 3. You can use negative 4, negative 5, negative 6, and so on. So if it's true, therefore all numbers, class, will be true after negative 3, including negative 3, class, because negative 3 is included. Once again, we have greater than or equal. It is included. So included, negative 3 will satisfy, therefore including negative 3. So once again, class, we'll be checking this region after negative 3, if it's true, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6, if it's true, so therefore all numbers will be true. So you can choose any number, class. It depends on you, which do you prefer. So you can have negative 4. So you can use negative 4, checking this region, or negative 10, that's okay. So after negative 3, that would be negative 4, negative 5, negative 6. Once again, you can choose any number, class. If it's true, therefore, all of the numbers, class, will be all true. So let's check that one. X minus 5 and then x plus 3 is greater than or equal to 0. So let's use any number class. What would be that number class that you want to use after negative 3? So let's have negative 4, right? So let's have negative 4. Simply substitute the value of x, which is negative 4. So negative 4 minus 5. And then x is negative 4. Negative 4 plus 3 is greater than or equal to 0. So negative 4 minus 5, that's negative 9. Alright, so once again, negative 4 minus 5, that's negative 9. If the signs are the same, simply copy the sign and then add the number 4 plus 5, that's 9. And then negative 4 plus 3, if the signs are not the same, you subtract. 4 minus 3 is 1. And then copy the sign of the larger number. So 4 minus 3, that's 1. And then 4 is greater than 3, we copy the sign. So that would be negative 1 is greater than or equal to 0. Alright, and then negative 9 times negative 1, that would be positive 9. Negative times negative is positive. 9 times 1 is 9. It's greater than or equal to 0. Question. Is 9 greater than or equal to 0? Yep, 9 is greater than 0. Once again, 9 is greater than 0. Therefore, class, the statement is true. So therefore, this one right here is true. So this is true. Alright, so this is true. So, okay, let me just write here, true on the upper part. So this is true. Alright, so true. Now, you check this region, class. Once again, if it's true, therefore, all of the numbers, class, going to the left, negative 5, negative 6, negative 7, negative 10, and many more, class, will be true. All statement will be true. Even if you check that one, class, even if you substitute negative 10, it will be always true, class. So just check one number, class. So we will have negative 4, and the statement is true. Therefore, all of the region, class, after negative 3 will be all true, including negative 3. Alright, so next step, class, we check this region. So you can use any number. You can have 0 or 1. So let's have 0, class, because it's easier for us if it's 0. So once again, simply copy this factor, x minus 5. The other one, x plus 3, is greater than or equal to 0. So our x is 0. Once again, class, we'll be using this region. So you can use 0 or you can use 1. It depends on you. You can use 1 or 2 or 3. Between negative 3 and positive 5. Of course, it's easy, class, if we use 0. So 0 minus 5 for x. Once again, x is 0. Then 0 plus 3 is greater than or equal to 0. So 0 minus 5, that's negative 5. And then 0 plus 3, that's positive 3. Is greater than or equal to 0. Negative 5 times 3. So negative times positive, that is negative 5 times 3 is 15. Is greater than or equal to 0. So is negative 15 greater than 0? Nope. Is negative 15 equal to 0? Nope. Therefore, class, the statement is false. So this is x. Because negative 15 is less than 0. It's not greater than 0. Once again, negative 15 is not greater than 0. So we have the statement, class, is false. Because negative 15 is greater than 0, it's not true. So therefore, in the middle part, this is false. Once again, class, negative 15 is not greater than 0. And negative 15 is not equal to 0. That's why we have false. We have x, class. This is false. Alright, and then last one, class, this region, and then we're all set. We will be using the interval notation for our solution sets. Alright, so last one, let's check this region. So after 5, you can use 6, you can use 7, 8, 9, 10. So let's have 6, class. Let's have 6. So we will be using 6. So this factor x minus 5, the other one x plus 3. Is greater than or equal to 0. So our x is 6. So 6 minus 5. So 6 plus 3. Once again, simply substitute the value of x, which is 6. So 6 minus 5 and then 6 plus 3 is greater than or equal to 0. 6 minus 5 is 1. And then 6 plus 3, that's 9, is greater than or equal to 0. So 1 times 9, that's 9, is greater than or equal to 0. Is 9 greater than 0? Yep, 9 is greater than 0. Therefore, our statement is true. Alright, and this is true. So therefore, after 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, all of the numbers class will be all true. Okay, will be all true. So therefore, class will be selecting the area which is true. So therefore, from this one up to this one, all will be true. So this is true. So after negative 4, all numbers, after negative 4 will be all true. Now for false, class will be erasing this one because we will not use the statement which is false. So we will be erasing this one for false. Once again, class, we only select those region that says true. So this region says true. So after 6, you can have positive 10, 11, and so on. So all of the regions after, including 5, will be all true. Alright, and then that's it, class. You're all set, and you can now make your solution sets. So once again, if you master in making solution sets, I'm sure, class, very easy for this one to make solution sets. So we can use the interval notation. So once again, when you make solution sets, that would be left to right. So we have an arrow, it means infinity. So that would be negative infinity. So once again, making solution sets left to right. So this is an arrow, it means infinite. So that would be negative infinity, comma, up to negative 3. Now since this is a closed circle, you will use brackets. Brackets, and then since we have two solution sets, we use union. So union, and then once again bracket, because this is a closed circle, bracket 5, then comma. So this is an arrow, all of the numbers after 5, including 5, will be all true. So arrow, it means infinite. So this will be positive infinity. And then if it's infinity, always use parentheses. That's it, class. All set. This will be your solution set for interval notation. Now, you can also write this one, class, on set builder notation. It's like this, class. The set of all x such that x will be less than or equal to negative 3 or x will be greater than or equal to positive 5. Okay, this is just the same, class. So for me, class, it's better to use this one because very easy for interval notation. But this is actually okay, class. Set of all x such that x is less than or equal to negative 3. So there will be including negative 3. So less than negative 3, it will be negative 4, negative 5, and so on. Or x is greater than or equal to positive 5. So including positive 5 and so on. So set builder notation, or you can have this one. Interval notation. So once again, class, I hope you learned something new today. If you like this video, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. You share it to your friends and to your classmates so that we can help more students. Once again, this is Teacher MJ. Have a great day, class. Goodbye for now. Bye-bye.